Hey everybody, Den Haring here for Fish Den 365, and welcome back to Topwater Tuesday. You know, recently I was at Ollie's and I came across these two frogs. They're made by the same company. It's 13 Fishing, and they were normally $13, and we got them on sale for $5.99, $6 a piece. And so they're both the same frog, but there's a walking version and a popping version. It's known as the Trash Panda, the 13 Fishing Trash Panda, Walker and Popper. We're going to review those today on Topwater Tuesday. So at first glance on these frogs, they look really nice, and so I thought they looked like they were pretty high quality just looking at them. The first thing I always check is how sharp are the hooks, and they're sharp, but they could be sharper. But that's nothing that a nail file can't handle, and when I'm done doing the video, I will file these hooks to be sharp to where I like them, which is I don't want to be able to scrape them across my thumb. It should dig into the thumb nail and stop. That's how I know they're good and sharp. So there's some good features on these frogs on what I read on the box. I'm going to show you that right now. So here is the back of the two boxes. The Walker's on top. The Popper frog is on the bottom. You've got some hybrid leg construction because there's rubber and flashaboo. Got a good 4-aught hook in there. There's a blowhole that's on the top, which reduces water intrusion. There's heat shrink seals, which stop water from getting in. There's a keel body on the walking bait, easy to walk a dog, and then an internal molded weight, which improves durability. These are all good features. These are, and it's nice that they write them on the back of the box. On the Popper, similar leg construction. The heat shrink seals are on that. 4-aught hooks. That same blowhole on the back of the body, which I thought was pretty good. You have the cupped mouth for the Popper action. And then again, that same internal weight. So some good things here that are spelled out in the boxes of the baits. So I was not familiar with the Trash Panda. So what I did is what I typically do. I got on Tackle Warehouse and I always like to look at the reviews that I see from there. And so the bait had a video that somebody was using it. The video was pretty impressive. And people had a number of reviews on the bait, and the reviews were mixed. And it was an unusual mix because there were people that either loved it way up here on number 5 or people that hated it way up here on number 1. And this was the walking version. I could not find anything on the popping frog. In fact, it looked like Tactical Warehouse had these on sale for $10 because they're on clearance. So I don't know if they're not intending to sell them anymore, but Tackle Direct and a lot of the other outlets still had them. So it was difficult for me to know how good they are. Some people said they use them on their tournaments, that the hookup ratios are fantastic on them. I mean, they wrote everything that would matter for a frog, they wrote in a positive direction. And then there were others who said that the hookup ratio wasn't so good, they couldn't walk the dog with it, it was too hard to use. And so when that happens, you know I gotta take it to the water, because oftentimes what that means is that you may need to do a couple of slight modifications to the frog to make it work the way you really want. And some people know that and others don't. And so if that's the case, we'll find that out when we take it to the water. Before we do, just want to mention what I thought about the construction of the frog. It's a good construction. I like the frog. It's not too wide. It's not super narrow, but it's not too wide. I like this blowhole being on the top. It's a soft frog. The hooks lay on here very nicely. They won't catch a lot of debris and weeds and stuff, but there's good separation when you press that down, and it doesn't take a lot to press it down. They're pretty soft. You could always make them softer by boiling some water and throwing them in there for 5 minutes. Personally, I doubt that these will need that, so I won't know that for sure until I actually fish them. But let's take some time right now and take them to the water and see how they work. All right, so we're going to try the walking panda here first. Nice color. Let's see how it looks on the water. See how it sits like we always do. Sits pretty flat. Move him a little closer here. So you can see how he sits.
makes a pretty big profile with that tinsel. All right, let's see how it works. We're gonna chuck it out there and see how everything's working here. Makes that nice splash on the water. Hopefully it'll walk the dog pretty nicely. Let's see. Yeah, she walks. She takes a very subtle twitch to get it to walk. You can also, I like that head bob. I like to make that, I like to see that white flashing as we're doing that. That's a, just as good as making it walk. Sometimes I think that's better than walking it. Make it do that, that's for sure. See how it's splashing? I like that. Make it run fast, stop it. Nice sound to it too. One of the things that would help it walk better is if we were to cut one of these legs a little shorter than the other. And also, I think the tinsel is a little much, so I'm gonna cut some of that off right now. I brought my scissors, and we'll see how that changes the look in the water and how it works in the water as well. So I'm gonna cut a little of that tinsel off. Bear with me here. We're gonna take it down to about half of what it is. There's one side. Take it to about half on this side as well. There we go. All right, now let's see how that affects it. Also, cut it back just slightly. And these legs are not too long, the rubber part. I'm gonna make one a little shorter than the other. And let's see how that looks in the water, first of all, and then we'll see how it works as well. Let's see, take a look now. Okay, so a little more natural look now because there's just less of that tinsel. Hopefully you can see that down there. Yeah, and you can already see it's walking better just in that short distance. Okay, so let's take it out there and chuck it out and see how she works. A couple little bluegills coming over to investigate. And now you can see walks a whole lot easier. See it going back and forth? And so that's how you can make a frog that doesn't walk so well a little easier to walk. Just real light taps on this to make it walk, but now it's walking really nice. Just real light taps, that's all it takes. But you can see I have a real nice tight walk now, look at that. Whereas before I couldn't make it do that at all. Now it's a really nice tight walk. Much better. Okay, and then the other thing about this, It'll still slap the water too, watch. See, I can still make it slap, and it's not gonna walk, it's just gonna slap. And that slapping I like. That, like I said, sometimes that's, a lot of times that's better than walking, making that head slap. And the frog has to be weighted right to do that. So now, because we made that slight modification with the legs, we can do both. We can walk it, or we can slap it. And it's nice to be able to have that choice. So we can slap a bit and then just start walking it like it's hurt. Slap a bit, let it sit, and then start walking it again. I've already talked to you about the features of this thing. It's been well thought out, scientifically made. All right, let's change over. We're going to cut this off and we're going to try the popping version now. So this is the popping version of this same bait. All right, and I'm gonna go ahead and fix these legs up right away too. So I'm gonna take a little bit of this tinsel off. I just want some of it, not all of it. Take half of these out. As well. Good. And then one side of the rubber will make just a little bit shorter than the other on the rubber. All right, so this one's set up and ready to go. Let's see how the popping frog sits on the water, and then we'll see. All right, so let's take a look at this frog now. As I'm talking, there's a green frog out here calling. So that looks pretty good. Another flat, sits just like the walking one does. This one is a, there's a couple bluegills behind it. This one's a popping one. So let's see how this works in comparison. Check it out there where that one just jumped. It's about right where that one hit on the top a little while ago while we were tying this one on. One popped on top. See if it comes. There's actually something swimming over. I can see by the wakes. That's probably bluegills. All right, let's pop this thing along a little bit. It's a bluegill color. And it's got a nice orange mouth. You can see that's showing up when we pop with it. Pops nicely. This one's almost primarily a popper. See it walking now. Just using the reel handle here to make it walk like this. Once you get it walking, it does all right. Not bad. So you can walk or pop this as well. This one's got more of a pop to it, where the other frog with the keel has more of that head bounce. All right, let's take it back to the tackle den and summarize what we learned.
Okay, so this is a great example of what I was talking about on the frog that walks, the panda, the trash panda walker. And that was It had a real nice mouth splash. I like when the head hits the water. That's one way to work a frog, by the way, and we've mentioned this before. You work it so that the head just keeps smacking the surface of the water, and it makes a lot of commotion. It looks like something's hurt or sick, and then you stop it, and you get a lot of bites that way. I think that actually is better frog action in a lot of cases than walking the dog with the frog. Both can be good. But this frog did not walk well at all until I made a few modifications. The first thing I did was the tinsel on here, there was a lot of it. It was very stiff and it was straight out, and it was kind of making the frog not be able to walk so well. It was actually acting as a stabilizer. And so the frog wouldn't walk. So what I did was I kept some tinsel on because I like that shine. I just took about half of it off and just cut it right off. And then the other thing I did was I left one side of the rubber strands the original length, and I cut the other strand about an inch shorter. And then I threw it out there, and you saw the difference that made. The thing walked really tight, really nice walk, easy to walk. It was unbelievable how much of a difference that slight modification made. This is why some people are probably saying this frog is great, while others said it stunk. So I made that modification, and I really like this walking frog, because now that I did that, I can still make that same slap the water technique. You saw that on the video where it's the head slaps the water, which I really love. It works real fast, like, and then you stop and then you do that again. It just looks like it's trying to get away. I really like that retrieve. It does that still just as good as it did before I modified it, but now I can make it do a real tight back and forth walk the dog retrieve as well. That makes this frog very versatile for me, and in my hands I feel it's going to be a very good frog to throw. So I look forward to fishing this and bringing more about this to you this summer. Now for the popping frog. The popping frog was unique in that, you know, I did the same thing with the legs. I didn't even test it out. I just took the same tinsel, cut that so that only half of it remained, and I cut one side shorter than the other. And so this frog popped nicely. It made a good bloop. It spit water pretty nice. It, you know, most popping frogs don't do that head bang, so it didn't do that. And at first, I couldn't get it to walk because I was probably hitting it a little too hard. This one walks, but it's a more subtle walker. It doesn't go so far back and forth. It's much more subtle, and you need to do real light tapping on the rod. But once you get it walks pretty good. So this one's nice too in that you can make it bloop and pop, which is really what it's meant to do, but you could also walk this too. And the interesting thing about this is the color of it. It's a really like an iridescent blue. It's got ribs and a black back and that orange face. And I think that color sometimes can be very good to throw. If I had to throw one and not the other, it's an easy choice for me. It would be the one with the keel. It would be the walking bait. It would be the one that was meant to walk because it slaps the water. You can make that good commotion with that. You know, it's a different commotion than a popping commotion, but it is a commotion. And I like that as much as or better than the popping anyway. So for me, this one is the better of the two. It's the one I'll throw more often. But there are those times when a bloop and a pop and a stop can really trigger fish, and this color being unique the way it is, I can see myself throwing this one at times as well. Well, I hope you got something out of the video. Certainly not all frogs are created equal. That's why we do these reviews, so that you can see for yourself how they're working, what they do, what are the pros, what are the cons, and that's what we bring to you on Topwater Tuesday. So if you like that, please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, because we're going to continue doing these as long as we can. Eventually, I think we'll run out of topwater lures, but I'm not there yet. We got plenty more to work on, so stay tuned. Keep it tuned here. And if you're interested in a frog that I'm extremely excited about, take a look at this video on a Six Sense frog that I did recently. Well, until next time, be safe out there. Hope to see you on the water, and as always, may God bless your fishing endeavors.